Welcome all to this tutorial. Today I'm just gonna first go ahead and clear the screen, and afterwards we will deal with a couple of commands, three of them to be exact. So we'll have rm, we will have move, and we will have cp for copying. Anyway, let's just go over them. The first one, well, rm is always nice, and RM is basically used to delete files, delete folders, delete pretty much anything you wish to delete. However, you should keep in mind that this is not like deleting in Windows. Once you delete them with RM, it is not very likely that you will get them back, or you could get them back, but you would need to invest a ridiculous amount of effort into actually doing it. And still, it would be rather questionable, so keep that in mind when using RM, especially when passing certain arguments to it which cause it to skip verification or something of a kind, and you delete a folder like full of things. But you can't always do that. Here's why. You can't delete a folder full of things unless you pass certain arguments to the rm command. This is a precautionary measure, to say the least. So I have test folder which has certain files in it, and if I say rm test folder, it's going to tell me immediately, cannot remove test folder, it is a directory. Well, what seems to be the problem there? So what? I know it's a directory, I want to delete it. And it might seem strange to you, but you can't just delete folders just like that, primarily because once you do, they're gone. The good place to look is, of course, the help page, and we are looking for the F command, dash F. So we, of course, as with all others, have recursiveness. And if you want your commands to be recursive to, I don't know, if they perform a certain operation on a directory or in a file or something of a kind, recursive generally means, as I've stated before, that they do it on their subfolders, and then they do it to the files within those subfolders, whatever it is that the command does. So dash lowercase r or dash uppercase r or dash dash recursive. I purely doubt that anybody actually uses this dash dash recursive. Usually it's dash capital R dash lowercase r. These things are universal pretty much. Any command that has recursive abilities will actually have these two arguments pretty much embedded into it. Anyway, if we move upwards, and there we go, we have force here, in ignore non-existent files and arguments, never prompt at all. So it will never ask you any questions, it's just gonna go through it, and it's gonna remove things, clear them rather fast, which is not a very good thing. Well, it is efficient in the sense of deleting files, but it's not a very good thing in the sense of recovery. Anyway, we will use the recursive and the force function today. So in order for you to delete a directory, you would need to delete its contents. So rm-rf-test. Voila, there you go, it is gone. LL, the test folder is no longer here. You cannot see it, you cannot find it. It is gone, permanently gone. Yeah, too bad. What can you really do about it? Anyway, be rather careful when using rm command. You can delete regular files with rm. Let's see what. So test 1, 2, 3. No additional arguments are needed, but like this, it's going to prompt you for. It's going to actually prompt you, and it's going to say rm remove regular empty file test 1, 2, 3. Do you want to do this or not? If you do, you type in Y. If you're not, then you type in N. So let's say that I am. And if I do LL again, it's gone. Completely gone. So let's try one more thing. Let's try to delete the file called Red Hat. And we're going to do that by telling RM not to ask us any questions. So Red Hat. And if I say dash F, press enter, you see, this is just gonna remove the folder, this is just gonna remove the file without any problems of whatsoever, but the same applies as with the folder. It's not gonna ask us any questions, it's not gonna care, you've told it not to care, and it will just go about things deleting them, which can be pretty bad. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and clear the screen. We have two more commands to process, which is basically cp that is copy, and here's how it works. From and then to. You type in cp, you type in the path to your to the file that you wish to copy, and then you type in the path destination, so source and destination. From would be the source, to would be the destination. Simple as that. Let's just go ahead and take a look at the cp help. So help, oh my, there's a lot of things here. Anyway, what are we looking for? Sure, we got verbose, but we're not really as I said before, for smaller amounts of files, it's not that important, but when you got 50 or 100 or 200 or 10,000, not a bad idea to have this turned on. Well, maybe not for 10,000, because you're not going to be able to look at them all, but let's say for 50, for 100 or something of a kind, it's not a bad thing. Anyway, what are we looking for here? And there we go. You see this recurring subject, this recurring theme with recursiveness, it's dash r, dash r. I'm just trying to make a point that other commands are also similar in terms of arguments. So if you got one set of arguments that you're passing to one command and they have a certain markation, they have a certain letter of the keyboard reserved for them with a dash, it is very likely that those things are general and that they are used in other places as well. So let's just continue looking through here. Again, you have the force command. You see it's pretty much this, it's the same, there is the same description as well. You can read through it, forgive me if I'm mistaken here, but I am 99.99% sure that this is exactly the same description as well. Feel free to look at it, I'm sure you won't get disappointed there. Anyway, we got it. Nope, don't care about that for the time being. Archive attributes, etc. Anyway, the only good option here for me is the force, and if you can use force with CP far more often than you should with RM, primarily because you're not going to mess anything up. So what? You're just going to copy files from one place to another. They'll still be there. They're not gone anywhere. They can't get legs and walk out of your system. So no problems there. Anyway, let's just go ahead and try to copy something. LL, what we got here? We've got file 01. So type in, oops, let's do this. So clear LL CP file 01. Also what is very much applicable is dash home. I'm just giving an example of a path. This can be typed in so many different ways for home, but no, okay, random guy, file 01. I would like you to copy this to the downloads folder. So go to downloads, and there you go, nothing too complex, and nothing out of the scope of understanding, I would say, just CP one path, and then another path, space, and then another path, simple as that. Press enter, and there you go, it has indeed copied it there. It remains here, but let's go to, well, we don't actually need to go anywhere, we can just type in LL downloads. And surely enough, you can see it there, it's the very first entry. File 01, no problems, it is there. Anyway, let's just go ahead and clear this. There's also another command which you can use, which is move. Move is also a way of renaming things. So let's say that I have file 01. I would like to rename it to file 0001. So file Actually, I would like to rename it to something better. I am here. Okay, think that should do it. And if I press enter, there are no new paths specified. We're only using the current working directory, which means that we have indeed just renamed something. Doesn't need to be the case, but here in this demonstration, I didn't actually move anything. I just renamed something. I just renamed file 01 into I am here. Not a big deal. That's how you change names in Linux terminal. Very nice. Unless you actually open up something and save it with another command. Anyway, where it says file 1, you can have a path to anywhere in the system where you have a permission. And again, where it says I am here, you can also have a path to this file called I am here, which can be anywhere in the system, again, as long as you have the proper permissions. I'll just go ahead and clear this. Yep, there we go. We can clear the screen now, just thinking that we actually covered them all. So what did we do today? We have rm to remove things. We have cp to copy them. And of course, we have the last one, which is basically mv move. So you can move anything from anywhere in the system to anywhere else in the system. So if I type in move, I am here to, I don't know, we can move it to wherever we want to. I can say downloads, mistake here, downloads, and if I press enter and ll, oops, there we go, downloads, take a look, it is transferred here indeed. So if I type in ll now, you will see that it's no longer in my current working directory. It has been moved out of there, it has been shipped away, it's gone, no problems. If you have any difficulty understanding or anything or something of a kind, please feel free to post me a question in the discussion section on Udemy. I am there. I check them several times a day. So if you post a question, you will get an answer within a 24-hour time frame. We've got 99% chance for that. The rest 1%, I suppose. I have no idea. Maybe I can't imagine what could happen, primarily because I do review Udemy several times a day. And if any of these things are unclear to you, please do not hesitate. Just go into the discussions and ask away. I will answer you. I will try to help you to the best of my abilities. Anyway, just wanted to put that in there to remind you. And for the time being, I shall bid you all farewell and hope to see you in the next tutorial.